money in itself doesn't intrigue you. A dare, Mr. Black.
Tonight on Black's Magic.
But I figured if you didn't want the 100 grand, I could sure...
You waited until I was out of town.
You're confessing to burglary and grand theft.
Oh, I was there all right.
Well, you know he's admitted to breaking and entering,
but not to murder.
We're leaving now.
It's showtime.
State-of-the-art gear, and mechanics don't come any better than me. It just can't be done.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Brand.
Listen, I gotta tell you that...
Good night, Mr. Brand.
Anybody cracks that system, he's gotta be Houdini. And that's a real long-distance call.
That trick can get very expensive.
You palmed it.
No. Still not there.
It's up your sleeve.
Well, let's take a look. Nope. But you seem like a bright young man. Maybe you can help me find it. Come on, come on. Now, what's your name?
Tommy.
Tommy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tommy. I'll tell you what. I'll look in my pockets, and you look in your pockets. Here we go. You found it! Tommy found it! How about that? Tommy, you can keep it.
Mint in 78. They're a dime a dozen.
Oh, so it is. Well, little girl, would you like to... I lost it again. Shows you how hard it is to hang on to a buck nowadays. Listen, we've worked hard enough. Time for a little refreshment. Would you like a nice, cold glass of milk?
Milk?
You don't like milk? All right, tell you what. If you don't mind, would you just hold on to that for me? No, no, no. There you go. There we are.
Get it off!
Tell me, Tommy, does that mean you're chicken or duck?
Oh.
How about a hand for Tommy? Thank you, Tommy. A little round of applause, please, for my lovely little assistant. And ladies and gentlemen, you've been a lovely audience. Thank you.
Thank you. How
How about some refreshments? Okay? Outside in the garden room, help yourselves. Very impressive, Mr. Black.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
For a moment, I thought you might make Tommy disappear, too.
Your son, Mrs. Perrin?
No. Oliver and I have no children. It's a decision we made even before meeting Tommy. And please call me Claudia.
Cheerfully.
Please accept the thanks of the entire hospital auxiliary board.
My pleasure. I would just hope that Tommy's mother has written a nice big fat tax deductible check.
Not as fat as she will right after the cake and ice cream.
Mr. Black, you don't look like a cake and ice cream man to me.
Oh, this is my husband, Oliver Barron.
How do you do?
Barron?
I have an excellent brandy in my study. Would you excuse us, my dear?
Yes, of course.
Come.
You have so many talents, Mr. Black, and your ability to get out of impossible places and things has been amply demonstrated. How good are you at getting in?
I was under the impression I was here to help raise funds for a children's hospital.
And so you were, sir. And you've done that admirably. I deal in gems, Mr. Black. Jewels, rare stones. And I have a problem.
Well, I could let you have 10 till payday if it'll help.
I have been asked to appraise a quantity of unset jewels that once belonged to Tsar Nicholas of Russia. My new security system is supposed to be the best, but...
But you're not convinced.
Now, it would be worth a great deal to me to know if or how that system could be breached. So in the spirit of a challenge, I'm willing to bet you $100,000 that you can't penetrate that security system and get into the vault undetected.
Against what?
Against nothing but your time and expertise. If you fail, I owe you nothing. But I sleep better. If you succeed, I'll write you a check. It's very simple. I know. The money in itself doesn't intrigue you. But a challenge. A dare, Mr. Black.
Now this is a bit more subtle. Do you know it would look lovely with your dinner? The setting is exquisite, isn't it? And absolutely.
Mr. Black.
Shoplifting, Mr. Barron.
Of course. You decided to accept, I see.
Did I?
Sorry if we kept you waiting, Mr. Black. I trust your daughter will enjoy this.
Oh, thank you.
You're sure I can't have it shipped for you?
No. I want to include a note. Thank you again.
Very good. Please come again.
Good day, Mr. Barron.
Mr. Black, I'm afraid I misjudged the situation. You are still considering my proposition.
I really hadn't thought much about it.
Perhaps if you could take a closer look at the premises, the vault, the security system.
Are you referring to the 6-digit Middlebury vault lock, the Ashton laser beam system, or the central alarm set behind the painting? I'm sorry I don't have time to look at the really technical stuff, but I'd like to get this off to California.
Right in the middle of Phil Donahue, the TV went bluey. Picture got all crawly, sort of. Looked like 10,000 dancing ants on the tube.
Call the cable people.
Didn't have to. That fella waltzed in right after. All I missed was the part with the three transvestites. You're really gonna pass on this $100,000, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Big mistake, son. Boy, this deal would be easier than watching ice melt. Anyway, you've practically got it all worked out.
What's this about infrared goggles?
Laser beams, part of the security system. You can see them with the goggles.
And initial access through ceiling?
Pop, I'm really not that interested.
Not in 100 thou? How come?
The challenge was to figure out how to do it. I've done that.
Right, exactly. Now think about the thrill of accomplishment. The electric crackle of the old nerve endings.
Pop.
What's the matter? Your nerve endings already dead?
First of all, that is not a one-man operation.
So we'll get somebody. Like Ozzie Frankel.
Ozzie Frankel? For your information, Ozzie Frankel is doing 7 to 10 in Attica.
Was doing. He's out. Saw him Thursday. Ace second story man. Look, son, have some popcorn. You know, with this plan of yours,
No.
No popcorn?
No plan. Absolutely, positively, definitely, no. But I will have some popcorn.
Something was wrong as soon as I opened up. The ceiling panel was loose, and that picture had been cut, and the laser beams were switched off.
The owner been notified?
Well, he should be on his way. He's always here by 9.
Well, he's late. We'll get the vault open, and we're going to need a list of what's missing.
There's nothing missing. Name's Leonard Black. I can save you boys a lot of trouble.
Let him through.
I'm going to make this simple for you. I'm the one who broke in here last night.
I see. You're confessing to breaking and entering, burglary and grand theft.
Legal, strictly legal. Sort of a challenge with Oliver Barron. The fancy ice is in that ashtray, right in the base there.
Tannen?
Yes, sir.
Get this guy's name and address and flag him a cab.
Yeah, you just come with...
Look, when Barron shows up, he'll tell you, and he better have his checkbook. Go on, take a look at the ashtray. The base.
Yeah. Nothing there.
Well, there's gotta be. I stashed it myself.
Yeah, you and a tooth fairy. Okay, let's see what's left in that vault.
Black's magic.
Black's Magic will be back in a moment.
Murder! Can you believe that? It's ridiculous!
I know that. You know that. Unfortunately, the police do not know that.
Now I suppose we won't get the 100 G's.
Forget the money, Pop! You're looking at prison! Don't you understand that? Oh, Pop, you were there. You confessed, for God's sake.
Oh, I was there all right. Our plan went smooth as rain off a slate roof.
Why did you do it? Why did you go in without telling me?
Because I believed in your plan, son, and you wouldn't do it.
Oh, Pop.
Now, don't sweat it. The lawyer says...
Frank was here already?
Yep.
Good.
For openers, he said to stop running my mouth.
Good.
Of course. That's just what he's going to use to spring me. You see, I confessed before the cops could give me that Miranda warning. Frank says this is illegal detention. I hope I'm out before lunch. They're having macaroni.
Mr. Black,
could we talk?
Don't go anywhere.
We met at the mayor's benefit. I was on a committee.
Oh.
Brian Latimer?
Oh, of course, Mr. Latimer.
Captain.
Captain.
Yeah, I didn't realize it. Leonard Black is your father.
He's guilty of that. What he didn't do was kill Oliver Barron.
Oh, really? Well, you know he's admitted to breaking and entering and to taking the diamonds, leaving your car.
But not to murder.
And we can place him in the building almost exactly the time Mr. Barron was murdered.
Captain, my father is almost...
Now, of course,
he denied killing Barron. In fact, we're looking for a... Ozzie Frankel, Johnny Wilkins. They can substantiate his story, he says.
Oliver Barron offered me a fee to test his security system.
Barron offered you money to break in?
A test. He was worried about his security. And I made the mistake of discussing it with my father.
Mr. Black, if I may ask, what were you doing last night?
Fishing. Lake George. I just got back into town.
Alone?
Yes, alone.
And aside from you and your father, who else know about this test?
Oliver Barron.
He's dead. Anybody else?
Stay tuned, Captain. That's exactly what I intend to find out.
No need to shout. I'm not deaf. I already told you it was an honest mistake anybody could make.
Some mistake.
Well, I figured if you didn't want the 100 grand, I could sure...
You waited until I was out of town. Ozzie Frankel, Johnny Wilkins? Johnny Wilkins?
Johnny was real handy. Ever catch his high wire act?
Oh. Sorry to have to bother you on this, Mr. Black, but I've been working on this escape mechanism all night long. The way it is now, it'll pick your head off.
Talk about a final appearance.
How many final appearances are you gonna make?
It's just a benefit.
But we still got time to adjust the release. I just wanted to check it out first.
All right, we better get at it. Pop, this will take a little while. Why don't you just relax? Don't touch the props.
Pop, do you have any idea how Oliver Barron's body could have gotten into the vault?
Damned if I know. I told you it wasn't there when I closed up.
You didn't see anything, hear a shot, nothing?
Nope. Nice, clean operation. Both Oz and Johnny were real pros.
Speaking of Oz and Johnny, where the hell are they? The police are out there looking for them. To corroborate your story, they've taken a powder.
Well, sure, Oz is still on parole. I guess he's not too interested in publicity.
You don't think it's possible they set you up?
Forget it, son. Two sweeter guys you couldn't find. You know, it seems like you're taking this pretty hard.
Taking this pretty hard? Pop, you are a suspect. You're the only suspect, don't you? Look, just sit here, let me take care of this, and then I'll take you home, all right? And don't touch anything.
Can I help you?
Latimer here yet?
Not yet.
All right. I'll wait for him in the office. Now, look, somebody's going to be coming by to pick this up.
But
you hold on to it.
Who?
He's here for Captain Latimer. I'm to hold on to this until,
What? Open it up.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Trying to get my father's name off a police blotter.
Your father? Wait a minute. Alexander Black, the magician, right? I took my son to see your show last year at the palace. Fantastic.
Thank you.
Wait a minute, Mr. Black. Hey, man, this is all off limits. I can't let you go through this stuff.
I have a fascinating question. Why would anyone break in here, kill Baron, make off with a king's ransom and diamonds, and come back the next day to brag about it?
Okay, so it's a little iffy.
Iffy.
But he's all I got till I get something better.
What if I can give you something better?
I'm listening.
You know, Lieutenant Calder, we work different sides of the street. I create illusions, and your job is to see through them.
I'll buy that.
Good. Why don't we take a look at the vault together?
How was he killed?
25 caliber slug, fired at close range.
Anything new on Ozzie Frankel and Johnny Wilkins?
Well, we got the net out on them, but I figured they went south.
I see you gotta admit that my explanation may be hard on your dad, but it is simple.
Oh, yeah. Simple.
Mrs. Barron, you say she had witnesses. Trustworthy?
If old money, social position, and connections count, yeah, I'd say so.
Well, it seems not everyone trusted her. Baron hired a private detective to have her tailed. It's all right in there. An off-the-top guess. Max Merrill.
One of us better be.
I'm Alexander Black, and I'm not carrying.
Oh, that's okay. I am. You looking for a private investigator, Mr. Black?
Well, as a matter of fact, my father's in a bit of a jam, and I thought possibly I could find someone to kind of fill in the blanks.
Yeah, I know. I watch television. I even read the newspapers. I know who your father is. But you don't need a PI. You need a good lawyer. And a judge you could put in your pocket.
I would have used the yellow pages, but Oliver mentioned what a wonderful job you had done for him, and,
Oliver? Who's Oliver?
Oliver Baron. Charming man.
Dead man. And you're wrong. I never worked for him.
Really? Well, my mistake.
Everyone's entitled to one. You just had yours.
In a moment.
We seem to have tragedy in common, don't we? First my husband, and then... I know you must be worried.
Oh, I think Pop will be exonerated pretty quickly.
I didn't mean your father.
Me? I'm not worried about myself. Should I be?
Well, Captain Latimer said you planned the break-in.
Because your husband asked me to test his security system.
That's what the captain said you said.
You mean your husband never told you about that?
No.
That's funny. I had the impression that my appearance at that children's party was merely a way of introducing me to Oliver so that he could drop the idea on me. Did he tell you what was in the vault?
He said he was just doing an important appraisal, that's all.
Important appraisal indeed. 15 million in Russian diamonds. Funny he never mentioned it.
Mr. Black.
Alex. First names, remember?
Remember, Alex. Oliver and I did talk from time to time about the seating arrangements at business dinners and gifts for his business contacts, advertising budgets.
Sounds more like articles of incorporation than I, Oliver, take thee, Claudia.
If you'd excuse me, I think...
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make a bad day worse.
Look, I kept the faith, Alex. Believe what you like.
The question is, did Oliver?
What do you mean?
Does the name Max Merrill mean anything to you?
No.
Let me buy you another cup of coffee. Hello, Pop.
Jason, the cops.
What? Cops here?
Here, right. They came about an hour ago with a warrant. It's time to hit the brakes.
Wait a minute. They're looking for the diamonds here?
Mr. Black, we just finished searching your apartment.
Oh, I assume the other suspects will be given equal time?
What other suspects?
Oh, Ossie Frankel, Johnny Wilkins. You are still looking for them?
We found them, Mr. Black.
Well, good. Then they confirm Pop's story?
Lieutenant?
Hands behind you, please, Mr. Black.
What is called?
We found Franklin Wilkins in the East River.
What?
Oz and Johnny?
Where you put them after you shot them. Show him.
We found this in your bottom bureau drawer.
Call them, we'll read you your rights on the way downtown, Mr. Black. The two accomplices were an obvious liability, so you dealt them out.
Let me get this straight. I mastermind a multi-million dollar jewel heist, kill three people to cover my tracks, and then hide the murder weapon in my sock drawer? Ingenious.
Maybe you gave the gun to your father to get rid of. Maybe his mind wandered.
You're missing the big picture, Captain. All you've got is the frame.
He does have a point, sir. I mean, the piece was cleaned. Why wipe off the prints and then leave it in your own apartment?
We're dealing in evidence, Lieutenant, not opinions.
Look, we're wasting valuable time here, particularly mine. I'd like to talk to my lawyer.
You don't understand. You're not walking.
And you don't understand. You're the cop, not the judge.
Okay, come on. Move it. All right, hold it right here. Okay, Eddie, bring the bus up.
Hey, man, you want a cigarette?
Yeah, give me one, man.
All right, get your bodies on board. Come on, men. Chester.
You.
Yarber.
Yo.
Rodriguez.
Si.
Black. Where's Black?
While I'm in the commissioner's office telling him we got it all buttoned up, you let him walk!
Captain, he pulls some kind of magic on.
Stake out Black's place, cover the airport, get his picture in every patrol unit. I want Black, and I want him before it hits the papers. Have you got that?
What about the father? You want him scooped up?
No. I'll put a tail on him and pray he leads you to Black.
Sorry I missed the bus.
Well, you miss one, there's always another one, right? Kevin! Kevin! Trace this call. By the way, is this a long-distance call?
Oh, I thought I'd stick around.
Look, Lieutenant, I could have called my lawyer, made bail, but to tell you the truth, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
So let me get to the point of this call.
When you searched my place, did you happen to find an electronic bug?
Lieutenant?
Look, you're still holding an empty bag. You really have nothing to lose.
Yeah, and some pretty sophisticated stuff, too, including a phone.
Thanks, I owe you one. Head for Central Park.
Well, what a surprise. I just heard the news. Everybody's looking for you.
Hey, when you're hot, you're hot. If I had stolen 15 million in diamonds, would I still be in New York? Would I be splitting cab fare with the wife of the man I'm supposed to have killed? Believe me, I would be far from the reaches of the law, somewhere in deepest Newark.
I probably believe you.
Well, I'm probably relieved to hear that. Because I have a personal question to ask you. Why did Oliver hire that detective to tail you? Now, you ducked this question last time I asked it.
I filed.
Filed, as in divorce. And Oliver wasn't too thrilled to hear about that.
No, he did not like that.
He thought there was another man?
He was hoping there was another man. Our money is my money. An inheritance. Oliver had very little money of his own.
And Max Merrill never caught you with the wrong guy?
I was never with the wrong guy.
Well, money wasn't the motive. Jealousy is out. I guess that means you didn't do it either, son of a gun.
Satisfied?
Well, I am if you are.
Good.
I knew Ozzy when he was just a kid working the short change dodge at Coney. And Johnny was supporting his mother in Queens.
You sure you weren't followed?
No. I got the note you slipped the doorman. Left the cops at the starting gate.
I don't get it. Same night I picked to go in with Ozzy and Johnny, somebody else decides to hit Baron. Is that lousy luck or what?
Not luck, Bob. War coincidence.
You said you had trouble with the cable TV?
Smart fella, too. Must have worked half an hour on it.
You sure that's all he worked on?
Wait a minute. While he was fixing the picture?
He was planting bugs. You and the boys must have discussed the plan pretty thoroughly, huh?
You kidding? Two whole nights. Every doggone detail. We handed the sucker the gosh darn playbook.
You sure the vault was locked when you left?
Of course. There was still a ton of rocks in there. Uh-oh. Those are either cops or they've seen your act. Black, I know you guys have been following me all over town. I'm willing to surrender. I give up. Look, I can explain everything, but just don't shoot me. That's
all. Hold it, police!
I'm telling you, fellas, it's me you want, and I'm willing to make a clean breast of it.
Come on.
Hey, come on, arrest me. I'm willing. This couldn't have happened to me back in Kansas City.
Thank you.
It's him, the cable guy.
Wrong. His name is Max Merrill. He's a detective.
Detective? What kind of detective?
He's the guy Baron hired to keep tabs on his wife. Our apartment was bugged right after my meeting with Baron. I'm betting so was Baron's.
So he had the inside track on everybody. Oz and Johnny?
Well. They were able to back up your story. Guess they were just loose threads that had to be taken care of.
He stashes the gun in our apartment. And now he heads for South America with 15 mil in unset stones. While we take the heat. Damn it, son, I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry yet. He's still in town, which means he probably hasn't gotten rid of the stones yet. Keep your eyes open just in case he comes back. I'll need about 20 minutes.
Should have brought a TV.
Why? What's on?
Who cares? Even Howdy Doody is better than watching paint flake.
You've been trying to reach me.
You have some merchandise to dispose of.
Osterman?
That name will do. You understand I will have to examine the merchandise before I put the wholesale value on it.
When?
Do you know Morris's on 47th Street?
Yeah, I know it.
Back booth, 4 o'clock.
Time to rearrange a few props.
So I tell him, you pay the ticket, buddy, or get yourself another driver. So he tells me,
I tell you just how it's gonna go, Osterman. It's gonna be a nice, clean deal. Cash. Up front.
Is this some kind of joke? These stones are fakes.
Black's magic will return in a moment.
Thanks, Wally. You've still got great hands there. Here's a couple of tickets to my son's benefit. It'll be terrific if he's not in jail.
Anytime, Lenny. Hope you guys beat this one.
Love to Gladys.
The envelope, please.
Thank you. Merrill's packing a 45.
Yeah, I know. I saw it. By the way, where's my change?
Change for what?
Pop, I gave you $1,000 for those paste diamonds.
Oh, I had to go another $300. But don't worry, just add it to my split.
What split?
From the insurance company. You know, a little finder's fee. My half had set me up somewhere in the sun. Maybe my own little grass shack in the Caribbean.
Well, one little snag, Pop. If I hand these over right now, they become Exhibit A at our murder trial.
So much for little grass shacks.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we ought to put it in gear, then.
You to the pool hall, me to the aftershave. Speaking of which...
Oh.
Oh. Oh, you like that, don't you? That make you feel good? It does. Oh, darling, you are such a good kisser. You are such an animal.
It's the aftershave.
Just think, we won't have to hide anymore. We've done it.
And Merrill never took a tumble. Never caught on.
Well, don't take all the credit. Who talked Oliver into letting you test his security?
True. But it was my idea to have Pop switch the real gems for the fakes.
Mm-hmm. I wonder who did kill Oliver.
What's the difference?
We didn't have to.
It's true.
Forget about it. We've got the diamonds.
We've got each other. And we've got 2 tickets to Hong Kong. That better be our guy.
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
This is Claudia Baron. Can you hear me?
Yeah, Mrs. Baron. This is a friend. I wish to confirm the terms of our contract. My clients are in agreement When shall we expect delivery?
We'll be on flight 107 at midnight.
Excellent. I personally will meet your plane in Hong Kong.
Goodbye.
It's all arranged. All we have to do is pick up the diamonds and get to the airport.
That means we've still got an hour.
So it does.
Right on schedule.
Eddie's pool hall.
Still got your stake down, Pop?
Are you kidding? Cops coming out of the woodwork. Just made $5 off one of them at 8-ball.
It's showtime.
We're leaving now.
My treat. You bought lunch.
Wow.
Nothing like the real thing, hey, Black?
I could let you have the same thing in paste for a really good price.
Alex, who is that man?
I have the uncomfortable feeling that this is the man who killed Oliver.
You know, you two were very good. Baron thought you had something going on the side. He just didn't know with who. Even I might have missed the connection if I hadn't wired your place and yours.
That's how you knew which night the test was going down.
You told Baron, who of course wouldn't think of allowing anyone to crack his vault without protection. You were it. Am I close?
Close, yeah.
The two of you were hiding in Baron's office when Pop and his pals came down. Right?
Right. Baron wouldn't trust anyone, even you, Black.
As soon as they left through the ceiling, Baron wanted to check his diamonds, which put you in the vault with the only witness. So you shot him. You even knew where Pop had stashed the stones.
That's right, in the ashtray. Then the rest was just going exactly by the numbers. See, I locked the vault, grabbed the diamonds, and then went right up the spout. Really clean.
Right down to planting the murder weapon in my apartment.
Hey, Black, for 15 million, I take no prisoners.
Tell me, was killing Baron part of the plot right from the top?
Yeah, right from the top. Which, by the way, brings us here.
So, now you're going to...
No. He's not going. You see, the police are here. They've overheard every word.
Bluffing with a pair of deuces, are we?
Might as well put down that gun, Merrill. The police are all through the theater. They're all through the house. Right? Pop?
Maybe they couldn't get tickets.
Hello?
The diamonds, Black. Open the box.
Those shots.
It's all right, Lieutenant. It's all right here.
Copy.
I'd like a receipt for these.
Told you I owed you one.
Let me ask the obvious question, Bob. Where were you in the police?
I know it's hard to believe, son, but they were right behind me, tailing me like we planned. Then all of a sudden, nobody. I lost them. I had to go back and let them find me again.
It was fortunate you got there when you did.
Yeah, fortunate. Went from slightly embarrassing to downright dangerous.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. Wish I knew how I lost those boys. Sure would come in handy someday.
Oh,
thanks, son. I get carsick in the back.
St. Elsewhere, death stalks the halls of the hospital when the Mad Bomber strikes again. And later, Johnny welcomes Don Rickles and Pete Fountain to The Tonight Show starring Johnny Carson.
I'm Brian Gumbel. Tomorrow morning on Today, the new budget gospel, according to Graham Rudman.
I'm Jane Pauley. Also, Tony Curtis and Cher.
Join us tomorrow morning on Today.